A very good morning to all the teachers who are joining us from Jagtial, and welcome to the second day of Gurushala's training session on how to use Gurushala to create lesson plans. Yesterday, we received a very enthusiastic participation from all the teachers of the Jagtial district, where we covered different concepts of lesson plans and how during this lockdown period where all the teachers are at home and all the students are also at home, how the from the remote mode lesson plans can be created and also how they can be implemented effectively. That is something which we will discuss today, where we will talk about the digital interactive books that can be created using Google Forms to implement the lesson plans effectively. Before we begin, we would like to mention that Gurushala is an initiative of Indus Towers and Vodafone Foundation, and our content partner is Jigyasa, and the program is implemented by Pratham Education Foundation. We would also like to tell all our teachers that yesterday we had given a task, and many of the teachers have submitted the task yesterday, and we have the names of the winners and some special mentions who will be winning some exciting prizes, whose names will be announced at the end of today's session. So please do stay tuned till the end of the session to know if you are one of the winners. So before we move forward, Ipshita, what are some things that our audience can keep in mind during the training?
Right. Thanks, Masood. Good morning, dear teachers, and welcome to the day two of the training session today. So before we go ahead into the training session, let's have a quick look at what are the various things that we need to keep in mind during the training. So first of all, we can keep a notepad and a pen handy with us so that any new information that is being shared with us during the training session, we can readily note that down, and then we can have a look at it later. During the training session, me and Masood will also, like yesterday, play some games and have interactive activities with you, for which you can share your answers and comments in the YouTube chat section. In case of any query or question you might have during the training session, you can also share the same in the YouTube chat section. We would request all the teachers to kindly use English while typing on the YouTube chat section. At the end of the day two session, a Google form will be shared with all the teachers for recording their attendance and feedback. For any kind of updates and any kind of activities that goes around Gurushala's platform, please like, share and subscribe to Gurushala's YouTube page. And I would also like to mention here that a certificate of participation will be given to all the participants that will be successfully submitting the Google form at the end of day two session, that is today. And they will be receiving a certificate of participation on email within 1 week of the training session. So Masood, let's go ahead into the training session and let's see what fun activities we have planned for the teachers today.
Yes, just like yesterday, today also we'll be having some interesting audience engagement activities, including Fastest Finger First, where teachers have to race against the 1 minute time and answer questions as well. So here is the first Fastest Finger First question for all the teachers, which is, what are the two types of lesson plans that were discussed in yesterday's session? And with this, the timer has also started. We would request all teachers to please share their information, to share the answer to this question in the YouTube chat. And let's see who answers the fastest.
Right. So like yesterday, it's kind of a recap, which our teachers also generally do in their classes, that they recap and revise the concepts. So let's see how much the teachers remember from the yesterday's session and see what kind of the two types of lesson plans that were discussed in the yesterday's session. So we would request all the teachers to please type in their answers in the YouTube comment section.
Yes, and yesterday, as we were discussing, that teachers in general, all of us make lesson plans when we are in the classroom situation. But when we are in the home learning environment, the planning and the lesson planning also automatically has to become customized to this new environment. So we would request all teachers, and I think Ujjwala Reddy ma'am is saying that the collaborative plan was one such lesson plan. Jannu Daisy is saying that collaborative and watch think practice were the two types of lesson plans. So these are some of the responses that we are getting. We would request other teachers to also share their responses. I think Ujjwala Reddy ma'am is saying watch thing practice as well. And Shirisha Boja is saying that collaborative plan and watch thing practice. So with this, our time is also up. And let's see what the correct answers are. So as the teachers also mentioned that the two lesson plans that we discussed yesterday was the collaborative lesson plan, the plan where we can teach a concept using interdisciplinary methods where you collaborate with other subject teachers to cover a concept which covers multiple topics in different subjects. And the second one was watch, think, practice, where you can develop the six core learning skills as highlighted by Bloom's taxonomy by affecting the three faculties of the students, which is watch, the visual aspects, the thinking aspects, and the practice aspects. And yesterday, Ipshita, we also looked at some resources on Guruśāla which can be used in to develop these different types of lesson plans, which we'll be discussing in more detail today as well. So today, we would like to tell all the teachers that we are bringing to you today a platform which can be used to implement these lesson plans very effectively using Google Forms. And we will be discussing the digital interactive books and how lesson plans which have been created, which include, you know, different types of resources and activities and tasks which you have identified within the lesson plan, can be implemented very impactfully using the digital interactive book. And for this, we will be using the platform of Google Forms. So Ipshita, if we look at what are the benefits of creating a digital interactive book for both for teachers as well as students?
Right. So Mashood rightly said that Google Forms can be used as a tool for, you know, assessment, but at the same time, they can also be used for, you know, effective lesson planning. So let's see what kind of, you know, benefits we reap out of using the DIB, that is the digital interactive book, as an educator or as a student as well. So the first benefit is that it helps students in organized learning. You know, as we see that in today's situation where there is so much, you know, we are adapting to this new mode of teaching, that is the virtual teaching, and technology, you know, comes into play. So it will also help the students into an organized manner of learning. Then if we talk about the student-teacher engagement, like in normal classes, we do have interaction with the students. We do have interaction between teachers and a student. So it will, you know, create that kind of atmosphere where a teacher and student can engage with themselves using a digital interactive book. So that both teacher and the student can have a seamless classroom experience and a teaching experience. Then talking about the third aspect, that is the assessment of, you know, students. So like many teachers have also said that what are the various, you know, strategies for having assessment during this time, whether to have an offline assessment or an online assessment. So in that case, a DIB can be very handy tool to, you know, for the students to have a self-assessment from themselves where they can answer the question and they can also analyze their questions, that whether they have correctly answered the questions. And if they have incorrectly answered the question, the teacher can also provide a, you know, feedback for that in this with the help of DIB. Then, as I said, the analysis for a teacher, it is very important to know that concept he or she is, you know, telling to the students, or the information that is being disseminated in a classroom, it is being grasped in a, you know, in a positive way. So for that, you know, analyzing the class performance, it's very important. And we do have that kind of provision in a DIB or a digital interactive book.
Absolutely. So let's explore what a digital interactive book looks like. And as we were discussing, that it is important that whatever content we are sharing with the students, as many teachers are sharing on the WhatsApp group as well, it is important to share it in an organized manner so that the student is able to access it in a structured manner and at a click of a button. This is what a digital interactive book helps us with. At the same time, because the student is not in the classroom, the scope for interaction is something which has to be looked at as well. So digital interactive books help us understand as to how teachers can give automatic feedback to the student based on the Google form. And as we also mentioned, that it is important as a big challenge as to understand how the understanding of the students is. Because when we are in the classroom, we are able to ask questions to students, we are able to understand how much they have understood the concept. But because of the distance, it is a challenge now. And this is where the digital interactive book will help understand individual as well as classroom performance of the students. So Ipshita, let's look at how the digital interactive book looks like. Today we are taking the example of civics, social sciences, a chapter in class 8 called Constitution of India. Let's see what the digital interactive book looks like.
Right, Mashrood. So here we can see, teachers, we have taken a very interesting topic of Constitution of India. Now, we can use, for introduction of a concept, it is very important to grasp the, interest of the students or interest of the audience. So for that, we can, use a hook methodology where we can give a hook or we can give, something of a fact which can grab the attention of the students. So like here we can see that we have given this did you know kind of a situation where we can tell the students that do you know that our constitution is the longest in the world. So this will create more interest in a student that they want to know more about the topic. And then we can also mention some facts like it was completed on 26 November 1949, but this was formally adopted in 1950. So this will also create an interest to know more why this certain thing happened in the past. So a certain kind of hooks can be given in the introduction part.
Right. So as you mentioned, as Ipshita mentioned, the giving a hook is very important because it's the right at the beginning of the content. So that's why it is important to make sure that the student immediately, as soon as he or she opens the link of this book, they are interested in it. What we have also seen here is that you as teachers can also record your own video introducing or giving an introduction to the topic like you would do in the classroom as well. So here is an example where a teacher has recorded a video of herself and is introducing as to what the students will learn by going through this digital interactive book. So Ipshita, let's play this video and let's see how teachers can give this kind of an introduction. As in, this is one example which you can use to create your own videos as well.
Right, Mashrood. So let's see how we can introduce the concept of the Constitution using a simple video.
गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, आई होप आप सेफ हो, अपनी फैमिलीज के साथ हो, कोविड के टाइम पे हेल्दी खाना खा रहे हो और अपनी इम्यूनिटी को जो है वो स्ट्रांग रख रहे हो। ध्यान रखना कि बाहर जो है वो जितना कम हो सके उतना जाना, घर पे ही खेल कूद करो अपने फैमिलीज के साथ, अपने भाई बहनों के साथ, पर बाहर जो है वो कम जाना और हेल्दी खाना खाते रहना। तो चलो आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है उसको शुरू करते हैं और वो उस टॉपिक का नाम है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया, यानी भारत का संविधान। इस टॉपिक के बारे में हमने क्लास 6th और 7th में भी जाना है, पढ़ा है, तो हमें कुछ ब्रीफ आइडिया है इस टॉपिक के बारे में। आज जो है हम इसके बारे में कुछ
नई चीजें as we can see in this video that the teacher is wishing the students well first of all, and then after that the teacher is telling the students that today in this book we are going to read about the Constitution of India and then also give a background as to this topic has also been covered to some extent in classes 6th and 7th. So what the sudden disconnect which the lockdown has got is something which the digital interactive book can help reduce by making the students relate to what the concept they are learning about was connected with their previous classes as well. So this is, as we see, Ipshita, the very first page of the digital interactive book which automatically connects the teacher with the student. Now if we go on the next page, what we also can see that there are more such videos and more such questions given as well. So if we can look at the very first video, it is a concept video, Ipshita, which teachers can find from the internet and use it on the digital interactive book, Ipshita.
Right, Mashrood. So, teachers, as we saw that we have now introduced the concept and we have grasped the interest of the students, it's very important to now take it step by step, and then we can introduce the concept in a broader form. Firstly, we can give the introduction of the concept, and then we can elaborate the concept using a concept video. So let's see over here that how a concept video can be used for introduction of the concept. That is we're talking here about the need. Why do we need the Constitution? So let's have a quick look on the video.
Why do you think the umpire has given the free hit for the batsman? Yes, the bowler has crossed the crease completely, which is considered as no ball. You all know the rules of cricket. Similarly, in football, the player should not touch the ball with his hand. In every game, we have some rules, and these rules help define the game and helps us distinguish one game from another. Do we have such rules in our society? Yes, like these games, a society also has constitutive rules that make it what it is and differentiate it from other kinds of societies. In large societies, in which different...
What we see in this video is basically the concept being introduced to the students. And so introduction videos are types of videos which very briefly either end with a question for the student, or they deliver the introduction. They kind of make the students introduced or acquainted with the concept for the first time before we move on to the actual in-depth concepts. And here we can see, Ipshita, that the example of cricket is being used in this video because cricket is something which is a popular sport and children are able to connect to it. So giving real-life examples in the introduction video where you are introducing the concept is also very helpful. What we can see is that there are some questions also based on the video which are given in the digital interactive book.
Right, Mashood. So it is very important to give some leading questions after the concept has been introduced, just to see that whether how much the child has grasped the information. So the questions here I would like to mention can be in any many formats. Like we can give MCQ kind of questions over here, where the child can choose out of the options the correct option. So for example, here I will take an example that which of the following is not a reason for a country to have a constitution. So here the four options can be given. The child can select the answer, or if he's not satisfied with all these options, he can also write in over here that what can be an ideal option for the question. So we can choose from here amongst these MCQs. Also, Mashood, I would like to mention here that you can also use certain situation-based questions over here. Like here we can see that a certain situation is given, just to know that what is the viewpoint of the child, or what is the viewpoint of a student regarding a particular situation. It can be a short answer type, it can be a long paragraph also, and teacher can give it accordingly to the students.
Absolutely. What we can also see is that you can also use images from the textbook. Because textbook is something which students are, many students, I think more than 90% of the students, teachers have said that the students have the textbook material and the reference material. So even if they don't have it, this is a very good medium where you can take images from the textbook and put it on the digital interactive book. And on the basis of that text, you can give certain questions. As we looked at, the one type of the question that we have is the multiple choice question, where there is only one correct option. And you can also have the other options where the student can choose which kind of answer if they want to give on their own as well, some additional answer. So this is the multiple choice question. Then secondly, as Ipshita mentioned, there is the short text answer question, where it is a subjective question where students can type the answer. Of course, now this is more applicable where students have access to devices, and more from the children of class 6 to 12, where they can, they have good skills of typing as well. This is where the digital interactive book can be used more. And then, as we said, that it is important that we give videos, resources, images also, but we also ask questions as well. So the second type of question which we can see below the textbook snapshot is the checkbox question. So Ipshita, in what situations can a checkbox kind of a question be given to students?
Right. For example, if we talk about the difference between a multiple choice question and a checkbox question, very important difference over here is that in a multiple choice question, you can give one option that can be correct and another's option can be used. But in a situation where more than one option is, can be considered as correct. So here a checkbox situation or a checkbox, question can be given to the child. We can choose on the basis of, answers, what kind of a question we are going to give, whether it's going to be an MCQ type question or a checkbox kind of situation. Here, Mashrood, we can also see that we have another type of question, that is a drop-down box question, where, it can be a substitute of fill in the blanks. Like we had seen that previously, teachers could give fill in the blanks kind of a question or one word substitution question. So here the child can, out of all these options can choose only one question from here. So here a drop down box kind of a question can also be given.
Right. So drop down is another aspect where the difference between the drop down and the multiple choice question is, and we'll also see how you can create such digital interactive books and add certain questions like this in the coming part of the session as well. The difference is that in the checkbox you don't have the option to give other options where the student cannot type an answer on his or her own, but in multiple choice question you have that option as well. So Ipshita, as we were also mentioning that you can, our audience can notice that every question has points as well. You can choose the number of points which you want to give for each and every question. Just like in our question papers, there are 1 mark question, 2 mark questions and 5 mark questions. You can choose what kind of marks you want to allocate for each question. As we can move forward also, you can see that there are more such videos given. Which can be embedded from the YouTube website as well. And towards the end of this session, towards the ends of this page, you will see more such questions coming up.
Right, Mashrood. So as we also talked about a very innovative concept of flipped classroom yesterday, so we can incorporate that concept over in the DIB also. That is our digital interactive book, where we first introduce the concept using a text file or a video file. As we can see here, we are introducing the concept of a fundamental right. So on the basis of watching the video, certain leading questions can be given to the child. And after the child attempt these questions, after analyzing the question, we can have a broad discussion in the classroom. So we can see that we have a video file over here. Similarly, Mashrood, we can also use, as I said, we can give a page number in case, a certain net connectivity issues are there. We can give a page number or we can add a text file also over here in which the child can read the text and grasp some concept. On the basis of grasping the concept, he can answer certain questions based on that. So that can also be done.
Absolutely. So we can see that all the content, the knowledge and the assessment aspect. So both the Google form here is not being used only for assessment purpose, but it is also being used to structure the lesson plan and implement it and provide it to students at the click of a button. So if we go to the next page, Ipshita, we can see that there is a conclusion also given as well. So what kind of content can be given in the conclusion aspect of the digital interactive book?
Right. So after the introduction of the concept, then, giving a broad idea about the concept and also asking various leading questions, we can conclude the concept, giving various facts and giving various figures. We can also put in, like we have seen here, we can put in some articles or links to the blog so that a child can explore more about it. We can give in certain news articles related to the concept where the child can see the practical application of the concept as well. So here we can see we have added certain further reading section. We have added few links to various articles, news articles and blogs as well. And then we can at the end add a concluding video also, where the child can, analyze the video and then he or she can write an article or an essay on basis of the video.
Right. So let's see what the concluding video looks like. And we would like to again want all our teachers to now also think on the lines of how they can create a digital interactive book for their own subject as well. So we would like to request all the teachers to share ideas with us on the YouTube chat after seeing this digital interactive book, how they will create a digital interactive book for their own subject, be it math, sciences, social sciences, or language. So let's see how the conclusion video looks like and what kind of an activity or what kind of an action task can be given to the student based on this video.
మన జాతీయ నాయకులు డాక్టర్ బిఆర్ అంబేద్కర్ మహారాష్ట్రలో సతారా అనే ఒక ఊరు ఉంది. అక్కడ ఒక బడి ఉండేది. ఒకరోజు తరగతి గదిలో ఉపాధ్యాయుడు లెక్కల పాఠం చెప్తున్నాడు. ఒక లెక్క చెప్పిన తరువాత దానిని నల్లబల్ల మీద చేసి చూపించమని విద్యార్థులను అడిగాడు. మాకు రాదంటే మాకు రాదు అని చెప్పారు తరగతిలో ఉన్న పిల్లలు. ఉపాధ్యాయుడు దృష్టి క్లాసులోని ఒక పిల్లవాడి మీద పడింది. నల్లబల్ల మీద లెక్క చేయమని ఆ అబ్బాయిని అడిగారు. ఆ అబ్బాయి లెక్క చేయగలడని ఆయనకు నమ్మకం ఉంది. నిజంగా ఆ అబ్బాయి లెక్క
చేయగలడు. వి కెన్ షేర్ వీడియోస్ లైక్ ఇట్ కెన్ బి ఎన్ ఎండింగ్ ఆన్ అ వీడియో ఆర్ ఇట్ కెన్ బి ఎన్ ఆన్ అ సమ్ అదర్ ట్రిగర్ విచ్ మేక్స్ స్టూడెంట్స్ థింక్. సో ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దట్ ఇన్ ద డిజిటల్ ఇంటరాక్టివ్ బుక్ యెస్టర్డే వి వర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ ది 6 కోర్ లెర్నింగ్ స్కిల్స్. సో నాట్ ఓన్లీ డు వి హావ్ టు మేక్ స్టూడెంట్స్ రిమెంబర్ కాన్సెప్ట్స్ బట్ ఆల్సో అప్లై కాన్సెప్ట్స్, evaluate situations, and also create their own content as well, create their own new knowledge. So the 6 learning skills, it is very important that we develop all these skills by giving such resources and tasks and activities which using the digital interactive book can be given. And here at the end of this book, as you can see, that the teacher has can mention the student to watch this video and create your own essay on the life of the of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, for example. So at the end, we can then submit this. If the student is looking at the digital interactive book, they can submit it back to the teacher. And here you will see that there is an option to view the score as well. So when we were talking about the benefits of digital interactive book, one benefit that we also talked about was that student will be able to self-assess, or student will be able to get automatic feedback based on the digital interactive book. So as we can see, Ipshita, that when we click on the view score, the student who has attempted the book can now see the feedback for all the questions.
Right, Mashood. So as Mashood mentioned that DIV can be a very helpful tool for self-assessment amongst the students also, and it's a tool for analyzing the performance of the class as well. So here we can first see the score of the child, how much points he has got based on the weightage given by the teacher. That for example, we have given a test out of 11, so the child has been able to score 1 on 11. Then if we move further into the feedback session, so we can see here that the first question attempted by the child, it is incorrect. So in case of incorrect question, we have given a correct answer, and then a feedback can also be provided to the child. So Mashood, is it important for a teacher to provide feedback for a correct and incorrect question as well?
Absolutely. So we as teachers, when we are teaching in the normal classroom situation, whenever we take any assessment or we ask questions, we always provide feedback to students. For example, we tell them as to whether they are correct or incorrect. If they are correct, then we motivate them and tell them to learn more and develop more skills. If they are incorrect, we also encourage them and give them certain remedial resources or remedial content or remedial classes as well. So that is why in the digital interactive book, it takes this feedback process online in a digital manner. Here, as you can see, that the answer was incorrect. So automatically, when the student submits the Google form, here they can see that they first realize what the correct answer is. Secondly, they also get a remedial video which they can watch to understand this concept more better. So this way, the teacher automatically is giving feedback to all the students in his or her class automatically using the digital interactive book. So it is very important that the feedback be given so that students also understand what is the next step required for them as a learner, Ipshita.
Right, Mashood. As very rightly said, feedback is a very important aspect of evaluation or assessment. And being a educator, it's very important thing to keep in mind that while giving the feedback, it should be very positive and very motivating for the child. So he or she is, motivated or pushed forward to do better in the next assessment session. So similarly, Mashood, as we can see, we can give the similar feedback for all the incorrect or the correct options being chosen by the child. So this Absolutely. Is how we can create an interactive digital book using a Google form.
Absolutely. So we have seen now a glimpse of the digital interactive book as to how it looks like. And many of our teachers are using Google Forms, and they can also, we would like to request all teachers to share their ideas on for what purposes, what objectives they have used Google Form for in the past. We would request all teachers to please share their ideas, questions and comments on the YouTube chat. And we'll try our best to bring some of these questions and ideas in the session as well. Now, moving forward, before we actually get into the nuts and bolts and the creation of the Google form and to create the digital interactive book, what we would like to also bring to all our notice is what kind of strategy should we follow to ensure that the digital interactive book is impactful, it is interesting. So there is a particular strategy which we would like to introduce in front of all the teachers while creating their digital interactive book called the hook to action strategy. So it's a five-step strategy. The very first step of the strategy is the hook. By hook, we mean when the digital interactive book starts, right at the beginning. There should be some kind of a content, or it should be able to catch or hook the attention of the student immediately. And especially right now, it is very important because students are away from the teacher in the home learning environment. So a hook can be like we saw in the digital interactive book, it was a video or an interesting fact about the Constitution of India. And it was also a video of the teacher introducing the lesson to the students. So this is the very first step. The second step of hook to action is the concept. The delivery of the concept can again be through an image, through a PPT, through a video. And there are different types of videos which are available on Guruśāla and the internet, which can be used to deliver the various aspects of the concept. The third step of hook to action is trigger. And trigger is very important to develop the analytical and the thinking application skills of the students. Trigger could be certain questions or certain videos which have questions or give some interesting fact or interesting perspective, which makes the student think more about the concept. And not only think, but also take certain actions to learn more about the concept. Ultimately, I think all of us as teachers have this wish that students take initiative on their own to learn more about concepts more deeply. So this is where the trigger aspects of the digital interactive book are involved in the hook to action strategy. The fourth step in the strategy is of repeat. As teachers, we summarize concepts, we revise concepts, we do certain mock tests or certain practice tests before the examination. Similarly, the digital interactive book should also have certain content which can help us completely remember and kind of revise the concept which has been shared by the teacher in the book. And for that, we can also give certain resources which we will now discuss in more detail. And finally, in the hook to action strategy, the fifth point is action. By action, we refer to the student involving themselves in certain activities or certain tasks, which again develop their analytical application and creative skills. So these can be certain activities, these can be certain tasks which can be given to the students at the end of the digital interactive book, so that students themselves learn more about the concept and learn to apply this concept in the real life. So broadly, these are the five different aspects of from hook, concept, trigger, repeat, and action, which we should keep in our mind while creating any digital interactive book. Ipshita, now if we can go into more detail as to what type of content or what type of resources can be used for all these five steps.
Right, Mashood. So as Mashood explained the hook to action strategy, so let's see what kind of, you know, resources we can use for creating a digital interactive book in, in terms with hook to action strategy. So first of all, if we talk about hook is like, you know, introducing the concept and actually grabbing the attention of the student. So here, let's take a very simple example of solar system. So we have chosen here a trivia about the concept. For example, we can share various facts about the solar system or the universe, how the universe was formed, how the planets were formed, how Earth was formed. Certain facts can be shared with the student. Based on that, certain other resources that can be shared are a real life connection, reference to an event, narration of a story. We can also tell students about the Big Bang that happened, which led to the formation of the universe, or we can talk about the black hole, the formation of the sun. So these are all reference to an event. Similarly, if we talk about introducing the concept, so for introduction of the concept, we can use a concept video. We can use simulations. Simulations are an excellent way of teaching, real life concepts students. We can also give a concept slideshow. A teacher can also record the slideshow and share it with the students, or it can be shared in the PPT format. Then we can also give, a textbook reference to the students. We can tell them to go through a certain concept on a certain page number, and then we can have a discussion around it. If we talk about the trigger section, so trigger is basically, it's like telling the student to, think more about the concept, why a certain situation is happening in the environment, why a certain process happened. So for that, we can give a did you know question. We can, tell them to share a perspective about a certain issue or a certain process that happened. We can tell them, to share a story about it. We can give role plays to the students. Then we can give a situation where we can seek a reaction towards it. Like in connection to solar system, we can say that what if, air doesn't exist or atmosphere didn't exist in Earth, what will happen? Like, why moon is called a natural satellite of Earth. So certain kind of questions can be given to the students, which can create a trigger in their mind to think more about the concept. Then talking about the repeat section, as Mashood mentioned, that it's very important to reinforce the concept again and again so that it is retained better with the child. And that is what we also do in schools. When a concept is over, teacher summarizes the whole concept that has been taught in the lesson. So we can do that using concept slideshow, an example, a case study, or a textbook. Then talking about the last section, that is the action section. Now we have just introduced the concept to the student. We have also given them trigger to think about it, summarize the concept. Now on the basis of that, we have to see how the student applies this concept in real life. So on this, we can, on the basis of this, we can give them question answers to, assess how much they have grasped the information. We can give them a reference to a certain object and seek their reaction toward the situation also. We can give them to build a task. We can give them a task to build a model or, apply the concept and create something new. For example, we can tell them to create a model on solar system. We can tell them to write an article about, various activities that happened during the formation of a solar system, we can tell them to write about a particular planet in that case. So certain activities can be given and certain tasks can be given for the action section. So on the basis of this, we can create a checklist, for creating a digital interactive book.
Right. So what we have discussed is a lot of different types of resources which are there at the disposal of teachers, and based on the requirements of the teachers and requirement of the student, we can identify as to which resource do we want to use from the internet. And if we are, many teachers create their own resources also, they can get some ideas from Gurushala's content library as well to see the different types of resources available, so that you are able to create a digital interactive book which has all the elements of the hook to action strategy. I think so with this we can Ipshita, go to the Gurushala platform as well. Meanwhile, we'll take some questions as well. I think Gayatri ma'am is saying that the total evaluation of student, is that possible to get from the Google form? So that's a very good question, ma'am. In the Google form, as we know that we can ask different types of questions. For example, you can ask multiple choice question, you can ask short text questions. As we will see now, in the multiple choice questions, Google form automatically calculates the total marks of the students. You can get that information. But for the short, the text entry questions where the student has to type the answer, which are subjective in nature, that the teacher has to manually give marks to, that Google form will not automatically check. So that is one feature of the platform, and we'll discuss in more detail as to how from one glance, from one option in the Google form, you'll be able to see the whole overall class performance as well. So as we were discussing, Ipshita, yesterday we also took our teachers through the Gurushala platform. So if we can see as to before going to the content library, how can we sign in on the Gurushala platform?
Right, Mashrood. So here I would like to tell to the student teachers that you can use the URL www.gurushala.co in the search tab and enter, and you will be redirected to the portal page. This is the home page of the Gurushala platform. For signing in into the platform, you can see this arrow button. So many of the teachers, they have told us that they access the Gurushala platform through their mobile phones. So you can see this login button over here in form of an arrow. So when I click on this button, a box will appear in front of me, which will give me the sign in option. So that they can be three options for the teachers to sign in. They can either use their Facebook ID to sign in, a Google ID to sign in, and if not, then they can also register using their working mobile number with us. So for example, Mashrood, I'm choosing a Google ID to sign in. I'll be redirected to the Google Gmail page. And when I click in, I'll be again redirected to the homepage of the Gurushala portal. So this is how you can successfully sign in to the Gurushala portal and access the various sections or the various things on Gurushala.
Right. So once we have logged in, then we can go to the content library. And the content library has a huge repository of more than 8,000 free resources, which you can use and also take ideas from for the hook to action strategy. So if we start with the five steps of hook to action strategy, the very first step is hook. And we saw some resources that can be used for hook. Now, if we want to, for example, start the digital interactive book with an introduction video, something which develops curiosity in the student. So we can then go and filter on the Gurushala platform. As you can see on the top right, there is an inverted triangle. And here, once you click on it, you will be able to filter to the category of introduction videos. So let's look at how these introduction videos look like and how we can use such an introduction video in our digital interactive book. So we can see, yes.
Right. So as Mashrood mentioned, introduction video can be used for introduction of a concept. So using the filter of introductory videos, as you can see, we have various introduction videos. So Mashood, let's see, if we want to introduce the concept of algebra to the students, what kind of introductory video we can use. So here you can see, teachers, we have a thumbnail. Once you click on the thumbnail, you'll be again redirected to the page. And here you can see this orange button of view the resource. Once you click on this, the resource will start playing on the screen.
Chotu, I have a riddle. Would you like to try and solve it?
Oh, sure. What is the question?
I'm a number. Subtract 6 from me and you will get a cricket team.
I am a number. Subtract 6 from me and you will get a cricket team.
Right. So videos like these, introduction videos, they end with a question and they kind of introduce the concept to the student. And here also you see that the example of cricket is being used. So while, of course, this is more suited for a child of class 6 to 8, where algebra is being introduced. But for different levels, depending on which level you are teaching, which class and which subject, you can think of different introduction videos. In fact, you can record your own videos as well and then upload it on the Google Form Digital Interactive Book. And we'll discuss that in more detail. So we have looked at how an introduction video can be used to hook the student in a digital interactive book. Now, coming to the second part, which is the concept. So now to deliver the concept, there are many different types of resources. Yesterday, in fact, when we were talking about flipping the classroom, we looked at one concept video in which the circulatory system was being explained. Now, another type of concept video that we concept resource that we can use is the concept slideshow. So if you filter on the concept slideshow on the Guruśāla platform, you'll find a lot of different types of resources which are available. And let's look at one of these examples. For example, the tornadoes slideshow. And once you click on it, Ipshita, we can see the resource has different types of content available within the PPT, within the PDF. So here as we can see that in this particular slideshow, there is the concept is given there with certain images. And as we keep scrolling down, you will find more and more different types of aspects of the concept of tornado, which is given there. So what we can also do is that if we have PPTs like this with us, we can take snapshots of it, we can take images of it, and then insert it in the digital interactive book. And on the basis of this information, you can then ask questions as well in the digital interactive book. So Ipshita, this is the second type of resource that can be used in the concept part of the hook to action strategy in addition to the videos.
Mashood, I would also like to mention here to the teachers that these kind of resources can also be downloaded and can be shared with the students in offline mode also.
Absolutely. So you can download these resources from Guruśāla also and share it with the students as well. Now, coming to the third part of the hook to action strategy, which is the trigger. So in the trigger, the idea is that we give certain content to the children which makes them think more about the concept. So for that, we can use the did you know type of resources that are available on Guruśāla. And again, you can use these resources to create your own resources in English, Telugu, or any other language that your students are learning in. So when you filter on did you know, you will find that a lot of different types of did you know interesting facts are given in the did you know type of resources as well. So Ipshita, we can open one of the resources, the weather report terms, and see as to what kind of information is given in that.
Right, Mashood. So when I clicked on the thumbnail button, this is the Did You Know resources in which, you know, certain facts and figures can be given. And like we have taken the topic of weather reports. So certain questions are given, certain facts are given according to the question over here. And the same can be shared with the students as well.
Absolutely. So these are, again, certain resources and these type of resources you can use in the digital interactive book to make students think more about it, to trigger more information from them, to trigger more, deep thought within them. The fourth type of resource which we can use in the digital interactive book is also to do with the summarization or the repeat aspect of hook to action. So when we have taught the concept, let's say you have shared the resources, on WhatsApp or you have taken some online class, then after that, the fourth step is that you have to revise the concept. So one resource that we can use to revise the concept, which we also showed yesterday, was the case study. Now, case study, again, is a very impactful way to make students revise the concept. Yesterday, we looked at air and water pollution. So air and water pollution, if we take that example again, we will see that it is a concept of science in class 8. And here, the case study is it is basically in the form of dialogue or conversation between two or more family members. And the case studies on Gurushala platform, they are basically, they have characters which are relatable to children. For example, their parents, their friends, their teachers. This kind of conversation is given, the concept of air and water pollution is introduced using this conversation. And here, as you can see, there are two questions given. These questions are something now which you can also give in the digital interactive book. So one way to use case study in the digital interactive book is where you can take the case study, the images of the case study, and take a screenshot and put it in the digital interactive book. And then you can give these questions which are there, and the student has to answer the question. So the answer which is given here in the case study can be then put in the feedback part of the digital interactive book. So we will discuss also now as to how we can add that feedback into the digital interactive book, so that if the student has given the correct answer, they can be given some information. If they give the incorrect answer to these questions in the case study, in the feedback, when they view the score and see the feedback, they will be able to see the correct answer there. Ipshita.
Right, Mashood. So Mashood, we have seen that case study, how case study can be used to reinforce a concept or repeat a concept. We took an example of air and water pollution over here. How can these case studies can be incorporated into a DIB, and how the questions can be given, and how feedback can also be given according to the question. So, Mashood, can we tell us teachers about the last point, that was the action, point in the hook to action strategy? What content piece can be, mapped according to that?
Absolutely. So, the fifth part of the digital interactive book, which is the action, is something which is, which develops the skills of students, which gives them certain tasks which can develop the application skills of the students. So, for that, we can use the project. Resource on Gurushala. Here you will see that every project will have certain instructions, and it will have certain materials required, activities to do, and what is the learning outcome it is given in the project. So, for example, making a tornado in a bottle. Now, this is an interesting project which can be used to teach different concepts. And in this, when we click on the project, you can share it in the digital interactive book. You can take screenshots of it, where once the concept has been taught, you can give this activity to the student. It will mention, for example, what is the topic. It will tell what the materials are required. So here you can see a water bottle and some water is required. And the projects on the Gurushala platform are basically require material which can be which the child can get from around their house also. So we can help students develop these more skills by doing these projects. They have to follow certain instructions as well. And then once they follow the instruction, there is an explanation also given of what the project demonstrates, what do they understand by the project, that is also given here. So this is one example which you can, in the hook to action strategy, the project can be used in the action part as well. So Ipshita, we have kind of broadly discussed as to what are the different aspects of hook to action and what type of content from the Gurushala platform can be used by teachers to use resources directly and also create their own content using these ideas as well. So now we can now move on to the actual creation of a digital interactive book. And before we talk about the creation of a digital interactive book, we would also like to, before that, we would like to do a refresher activity with the teachers, a puzzle which is going to come in front of all the teachers, and would like to request all teachers to keep their phones ready because a puzzle is going to come on the screen. And there are three riddles, as you can see on the screen. The first riddle is, what begins with an E and only contains one letter? What begins with an E and only contains one alphabet or one letter? So who am I? That's the first riddle. The second riddle is, what comes up but never comes down? What am I? So this is the second riddle. And the third riddle is, I have a head and a tail, but no body. Who am I? So these are the three riddles. And with this, our timer is also starting. We would request all teachers to answer and, you know, attempt the riddles and also mention which riddle number. So you can mention the riddle number and the answer to it as well on the YouTube chat. And let's see who gets the correct answers.
Right. So we would like to say here that such riddles or such activities can be played in the classroom with students as well. Like we talked about, triggering their inquisitiveness or triggering curiosity in between them. So certain riddles can also be shared with the students in the classroom as well, Mashood. So here I would like to request all the, teachers to quickly participate and quickly, share their answers in the YouTube chat section along with the riddle number and the answer to the riddle. So Mashood, we are seeing that answers have started coming, like Virisha ji is saying that coin can be an answer, and for the third riddle it can be there. And with this, the timer has also stopped, and let's see what answers we're getting in the chat section.
Yes. So Virisham ji has said coin for the third one. Moturi Praveen ji has said coin for the third one. This is also an interesting answer, that there is a head and a tail but no body. Ujwala Reddy ji is saying answer to the second riddle is gas. We also have Sarita ma'am, who is saying kite. The third answer is kite, so that's also an interesting one. Afroz sir is saying ladder to the second riddle. What comes up but never comes down? Interesting that the ladder goes up but doesn't come down. So I think there are many answers that we are getting. Is there any other unique answer that we have got? I think yes, Rajesham sir is saying I. Which riddle is it, sir? Which riddle are you saying that the answer is I? If you can confirm that. And I think many other people are saying coin and kite. So a lot of responses that we have got. And let's then see what the correct answers are, and let's see which are the teachers who have got the correct answers.
Right. So the right answers are on your screen, teachers. For riddle one, it is what begins with an E and only contains one letter, that is an envelope. For riddle two, what goes up but never comes down, so it's H. And for riddle three, I have a head and a tail, but no body, that is a coin. So I guess, Mashood, for riddle three, almost, teachers have correctly answered the question, and still the answers are coming in the chat section. Teachers are sharing the answers with us.
Right. And in fact, we are getting more responses, which can actually, I think time is one aspect to which some teachers have mentioned. So time and age are related. So I think Janu, DZ, ma'am has also, I think, got it almost correct. So thank you to all the teachers for responding to the puzzle. And with this, now we can now we can move and talk about how to now create the digital interactive book. So what we would like to tell our teachers is that many of us are using Google Forms. So to go to Google Forms, you can make a Google Form on a computer as well as mobile phone. So if you go on your mobile browser also and go click on Google Forms, so there also you can create a Google Form. And then once you create a Google Form, a new Google Form, here we have already created the digital interactive book on the Google Form. So we'll now go step by step. And we would request all teachers to keep noting down as to what the different steps are. And anywhere if you have any questions, any concerns, please do share it with us on the YouTube chat, and we'll be very happy to answer them as well. So Ipshita, the very first step of creating the digital interactive book is to adjust its settings. So if we have to adjust the settings of the digital interactive book, what are the steps that the teachers have to take to adjust the same?
Right, Mashood. So for having a successful digital interactive book, it's very important to, set into the right settings. So teachers, you can see on the right-hand corner over here, wheel like icon, and which says settings. So you can click on the settings option and a box will appear in front of you. Now, three types of settings are there, one for the general setting, then for presentation and for quizzes. So let's go one by one through all these three sections. So for general setting, you can, keep the checkboxes unchecked. So, all the students can access it smoothly and they can submit their questions and answers to the questions very smoothly and, go ahead with the submission. Then if we talk about the presentation, so here also we can, give a confirmation message that after the submission of the form or after the submission of the book, what message the teacher would like to give to the students. For example, we can write a thank you note to them, and we can also write what can be the next step of the action. We can write that when the results or when the, assessment results will be available with the students as well. Such kind of notes can be written in here for the presentation section. If we talk about the quizzes section, as Mashood, you also mentioned that it can be used as an assessment tool as well. So it's very important to, click on this button and make it a quiz form. So which will also allow the grading or, assigning the points to a correct or incorrect question. Then moving ahead, we want to also, include the grading process into the DIB. So we can assign the grade after, the submission of any question is there. Then we can also click on the checkboxes for missed questions, correct answers and point values. So after successful submission of the form, the student knows what are the correct answers and what are the, teacher also knows that what marks they are being assigned to and what are the point values. So after successfully, setting the three sections or the settings for the three sections, the teacher can click on the save option and these settings will be saved for the form.
Absolutely. So this is the very first step where in the Google Form, these settings have to be set so that, and especially putting more emphasis on making the Google Form a quiz so that you are able to assess the students also. So this is the first step. Now, if you look at the second step, as we saw that in the digital interactive book, we started with an information or an interesting fact and the video of the teacher. So if you have to say the title, if you have to add a title to the digital interactive book, what steps can be taken, Ipshita, for the same?
Right. So Mashood, for addition of the title, you can see a bar over here. So for addition of the title, you can choose the first plus sign or the plus icon on the bar. And if you click on it, you will get the option of choosing the title. So for choosing of the title, you can, for example, be it telling about the Constitution of India, or the, you know, and we are choosing the class title also, we can give what kind of, you know, class we're using it for. So we can type in the title over here, and we can also give the description, what we want to type in for the thing. Like we have given a hook over here. Similarly, for any other subject, for example, science or mathematics, certain hook can be typed and, you know, introduction can be there. So right. We also talked, Bashud, about the certain video resources that can be added into the introduction. So for introduction video edition, we can add on the add video. You can see a play button over here. So when we click on this, so the video can be added into two forms. So for example, here a teacher recorded video of the teacher is present. So you can record the video, you can put it on YouTube, and you can paste the URL over here. For accessing the videos that are present on the you know, YouTube, so we can type in few keywords. For example, I type the keyword of Indian Constitution. So the videos available on the YouTube will appear in front of us. So when I click on the search bar, certain video options can be there. We can click and select the video. And when we select it, it will appear and it will be embedded in the form.
Right. So so what we observe is that in Google Form and Digital Interactive Book, if you want to embed or if you want to use any video, then it has to be uploaded on YouTube first. So if you are creating, let's say, your own video, then you will have to first upload it on your YouTube profile. If you have a YouTube channel, you can upload it on your YouTube channel. And then if you can use the link from there. For example, the teacher who's given this video here, she has uploaded it on her YouTube channel. Otherwise, what you can also do is that you can go on YouTube and search for any video which you think is relevant for the students, and you can copy the link of that video and then paste it here, and automatically it will be embedded. Another option which you can do is also to you can also go to Gurushala, because Gurushala has also two. So I think this is also one question which one of our teachers had asked. Yes, Rajendra Prasad sir had asked this question, how to download the videos. So sir, we would like to say that on Gurushala, we have more than 8,000 resources. So a very large number of these resources have been created by Gurushala itself, and you can download them as well. We'll just share our screen. I'll share my screen and just share it as well. So when we go on Gurushala, you can there are some videos which are curated from different YouTube channels, which you can view online on the Gurushala platform. So for example, this particular video on art and craft, if you click on it, it is basically, if you view it, then it is a YouTube video which opens on the Gurushala platform. So if you want to, so what the this facility has been given so that teachers don't have to search for, you know, on their own on the YouTube, but they can search on Gurushala based on the topic and the concept which they are trying to search for, and they will find that YouTube video here only. So if you want to add this YouTube video on the digital interactive book, so here you can click on, as you can see on the top, the original YouTube channel is also given here. The video is given here. You can click on this and it will take you to the original YouTube channel. It will take you where the video has been embedded. You can take that link and then add it to the digital interactive book. So that is one feature. The second feature is where you can download certain videos from Gurushala also, but unless you upload it on YouTube, then you won't be able to use it here. So what we would recommend is that for any video that you want to use, we can search on YouTube or upload it on our own YouTube channel and then share the link here. So Ipshita, we have discussed as to how videos can be put on the digital interactive book. Now, if you see that the very first page ended with the teacher's video. Now, if you want to start a second page, a new page on the digital interactive book, what step can be taken for that?
Right, Mashood. So getting into the section, like adding a section into the DIB or adding the next page. So you can see the last icon over here for adding the section with two bars. So when I click on this, a new section will be added into, you know, our DIB, and we can again, you know, see that we can have a title added to that. So if we see here, untitled section comes over here and it will see section 2 of 4. So we can additionally add a title to it. For example, we are introducing the concept of the constitution over here. So we can write the concept of constitution as a title. And then in description, we can explain briefly what the constitution means. As we briefly mentioned that we can also add a concept video using the same procedure or the same button over here. So hence, we can have a new section, like we can see over here, we have a new section ready with us.
Absolutely. So once we add a new section or a new page to the digital interactive book, the next step is we can, as we can see that there are questions that are given there. So these are assessment questions. So like we said that whenever we give any video or any image or any resource, always we should give some questions so that students, you know, try and independently learn more from that resource. So how can we add these different types of questions on the digital interactive book, Ipshita?
Right, Mashood. So as we said that questions are very important for assessing how the student is, you know, taking up the information. So for that, we can use this plus icon again and we can add the question over here. So when I click on this, a question will be added, you know, new question will be added. For example, over here, the question is added, new question is added. So with the example of the present question, we can take over here. So here we can add the title of the question. We can add, for example, over here, I'll take which of the following is not a reason for a country to have a constitution. And basis on that, we can choose the options also. So we can add in the option. Here I would also like to mention the types of question very briefly. So like we mentioned, the questions can be long answer type, paragraph type, then MCQs can be there, drop down boxes can be there. So we have an option of choosing it from here. So as you can see, we can choose short answer, we can choose paragraph, multiple choice questions, check boxes, drop down, etc. from here. So hence we can create questions on the basis of this, Mashood.
Absolutely. We are also getting a question from one of our teachers who's saying that the video time is something which needs to be also looked at, because lengthy ones may not be helpful as students might get distracted. So that is a very important point as well, that the videos that we are using on the digital interactive book, they should ideally be shorter. So, for example, we can search for videos which are, let's say, 4 to 5 minutes long from YouTube. And if, let's say, many teachers make their own video also, for example, screen recording softwares are used, and we conduct some trainings on screen recording software as well in the coming months, we'll be doing that. So those are very long, sometimes they become very long videos. So it is important that we use the hook to action strategy to make sure that within hook, maybe you give a 2 minute video. Within concept, you give a slightly longer 6 minute video. Then for the, you know, the diversity of content, you know, mixing content is very important, because the same kind of content might distract the child, as one of our teachers also saying. So it is very important that we don't keep very long videos. If we create a long video, we can edit it and make it into smaller, let's say 5 part video, and then use it in the digital interactive book. But as it's important that there is need for diversity as well, so we can mix videos and activities and different types of infographics as well. Some teachers are also asking us about how we can post our own content on Guruśāla, and also how we can post our own created PPTs and content on the platform. So we'll be discussing this in more detail. The Guruśāla platform has a suggest a content option, which we will explore in more detail. In addition to that, you can also go to teacher communities, any of the teacher communities in Guruśāla, and post, create a post as well. So we will be discussing about it in more detail very soon in the session as well. So Ipshita, now we have discussed as to how we can add different types of questions in the digital interactive book. Now, if we want to, for example, see if you want to allocate marks or grades for the correct answer and also provide the feedback, the very important aspect of feedback based on that. So what are the steps that can be taken for that?
Right, Mashood. So Mashood, as we can see on the left hand side in the downward section, we can see option of answer key. So when I click on the answer key, you can see that I have an option of allocating pointers or marks or weightage to the question. Then I have an option for putting a feedback also. So the feedback can be for the correct answers, just to give motivation or to the, you know, students. And feedback can be given for incorrect answers also, just to give a little encouragement to the you know, student to do better next time. So for pointers, we can add, for example, one mark can be given, or if you want to add more points to it, you can click on the upward arrow and can allocate 2 marks or 3 marks based on your you know, evaluation strategy. Then for adding the feedback, we can click on this icon of a pencil or edit button. When we click on it, so we have 2 options of addition of feedback. We can add an incorrect, for incorrect answer, we can also add in feedback. For correct answer, we can add the feedback over here. In addition to this, we can add some remedial, you know, resources or remedial content also, which can be a link or which can be a video, you know, based on the choice of the teacher that can be done. So here, for example, we have added, you know, feedback for the incorrect question in addition to a video on the Indian Constitution to explain the concept better. After this, we click on the save button, so it will be saved. The choices will be saved.
Absolutely. So so feedback is that one very important aspect of the Google form, which really helps teachers to completely decentralize, or, you know, completely make the feedback process for the children very independent, because every child can see the feedback by themselves. So it is very important to not only share feedback, but also share additional remedial content. If the child is getting incorrect answers, then it is important to share that remedial content, which can be done using the feedback option as well. Ipshita, we are also getting this question from Rajesh sir, as to can all these things be done on the mobile as well? So we would like to mention, sir, that absolutely this Google form can be opened on the mobile browser as well. So if you have any smartphone, then you can go on Google Chrome or any mobile browser that you have. Go to Google Forms, you can search that, and then it will open the Google Forms page. So you can create, as you can see on the right side of the screen, this option which you see, the 6 options, the plus sign and all the 6 options are available in the form also. You can do that. Additionally, we would like to also mention that the Google input tool can be used to write, to input text in different languages. So is my screen visible, Ipshita?
Right, Mashood, it's visible.
Right. So because many of us are, we work with students in different languages, we might be teaching them in Telugu or English or Urdu or different languages as well. So Google input tool is another aspect where if you type Google input tool on your computer or your mobile phone, then you can choose from a lot of different languages, almost 100 languages from across the world. And here you can then type, you can choose Telugu, for example, and then once you type here, you can you will get the Telugu language as well, and then you can copy paste this text and then paste it on the Google form as well if you want to write in the regional languages as well. So we would like to now also mention to our teachers that you can add images to the digital interactive book as well. So Ipshita, we were talking about how we can use images from the textbook or images from the PPTs that are there on Guruśāla. So how can these images be added, if we can also mention?
Right. So for addition of images, you can use this add image option, when I click on it, the add image option, you can have many options over here. So for example, for addition of a text file or addition of, you know, a screenshot of a PPT, you can first save it in your desktop, or you can save it in your camera, in your mobile, and then you can upload it directly from there. Either you can click the picture, and you can, you know, use the camera thing also. You can use the option of camera. You can directly use a URL where you can paste the image of the URL, and the image will be, you know, ready to use. You can also use your Google Drive and Photos option also, or simply you can type in the image. For example, we want to use an image of a constitution, or, you know, image related to fundamental duties and laws. So we can type in into the Google image search option, and directly the image will come, and you can insert the direct image into your DIB.
Right. So before, Ipshita, before we also see as to how we can see the responses and see the score which students have got in the Google form, we'd like to take some more questions. I think Fasiuddin sir is saying that they are already using language video lesson wise and send it to the WhatsApp group as well. So that's a very good initiative that sir is taking. We would like to also suggest that they can use the Google form or the digital interactive book method to curate or to organize all these videos that have been shared in the WhatsApp groups on the Google form, and then share it with the students. That way they will be able to, on a click of a button, see all the videos that you have created and sent it to them, and you can ask them certain questions also in the Google form as well. In addition to that, I think Subha Rao sir is saying as to how we can evaluate short and paragraph type answers in the Google form. So we'll as we were also discussing, that the short and the paragraph, the textual answers, are unfortunately, they cannot be automatically evaluated by the Google form. But for that, you will have to manually see what the answer is, as we will see now in the responses, and then give score, allocate score to the students as well. So that is one feature of the digital interactive book. So with this, I think let's now look at how the responses in the DIB can be seen, and how, what kind of insights can we get from the digital interactive book.
Right, Mashood. So Mashood, as we also mentioned, that you know, DIB can be a great option of self-assessment for students, and it can be also a great option for analysis of a class. So here, if we can see ahead, we can see certain insights. We can see the average points being, you know, calculated that the class has achieved. So we can see 1.14 on 11. So this can be score for the whole class, how much the class has performed. Then we can also see a bar graph regarding the same. So this will help the teacher to analyze the, you know, performance of the class, that how much more input is required from their end. And they can also discuss the various, you know, limitations for a good performance of the class or poor performance of the class. That can also be done. And then a whole analysis of the total responses counted can also be seen over here. That how many correct responses are counted, how many incorrect responses are counted. And then talking further, we also have a graph for how many times and how many people have, you know, answered the questions correctly or incorrectly. Like, for, we can see that for the first question, 80% of the people have incorrectly answered it and 20% have correctly answered it. So this will also give an idea to the teacher to how to, you know, give questions to the student, or how to set a question paper for the student based on their, you know, grasping capability as well. So this kind of analysis can be done using the DIB.
Absolutely. So as we can see, that the responses are something which you can see. So if you want to see the class-wise response, you can use the summary option that is there on the top three. As you can see, the summary option can be used. If you want to see question by question, as to question by question, how many teachers, how many students are getting the answers correct or not, then based on that, you can select that option. And the third option is the individual responses. So if we click on the individual responses on the top, then you will be able to individually see as to how many, you know, who is scoring how much individually as well. So these are the three options that we have available here. Now, if we look at how to share this Google form with the students on WhatsApp group, the link of it on email or WhatsApp group, what step can be taken for that, Dipshita?
Right, Mashood. So teachers, as you can see this purple button of send on the right hand side. So if we click on the send button, we have a box of many options. So the first option of sending this form to the students can be through mail, where we can type in the email ID and click on the send button. And the same can be, it will be appearing in their mail addresses. The second option, which Mashood said, can be through WhatsApp groups also. So here be an option of shortening the URL. So once we, click on the checkbox, the link of this will be shortened, and you can, copy and paste the link in the WhatsApp groups and share the same with the students as well.
Absolutely. So so we would really encourage all teachers to use this platform to create their own digital interactive books as well and share with their students. And in fact, we will be launching a competition on creating digital interactive books at the end of the session. So please do stay tuned for that as well. There are some more questions which we would like to take up before we move forward. So Arunasri G is saying, is DIB also reachable for the below average students? So what the digital interactive book is basically a resource which is designed, which has the potential to attract attention even from students who are not very top of the class or not very quick in grasping the concepts. Because what it does is that it gives, first of all, it gives that connection that the teacher can have their own videos up, they can upload on YouTube, and then you can put it in the digital interactive book. So it becomes like a book, but it is not just text. It is videos, you can put images, you can put questions. So automatically, even students who are not very comfortable with reading books, textbooks, are more attracted to it. So we would definitely recommend that even if there are students who are at a performance level below average, we can share it with them. Also because we will be able to identify what is required, what is the needs and requirements of the students. For example, if the student is not getting the answer correct, the digital interactive book will inform you as a teacher that this student is not getting this response. And automatically the feedback will also go to the student when they submit the form that they need to learn more. That is one question. The second question is coming from Froze G, who is saying that do we need to upload images or pictures also in the YouTube? So that's a good question. And we do not have to upload the images or pictures in the YouTube to use it in the Google form or the digital interactive book. As we saw also in the Google form, when you open the Google form, there is the six options which you see on the right. You can click on the image option. Ipshita, maybe we can open the DIB once again to show which specific option we are talking about, where you can click on the image and automatically you can use an image either on the, which is there available on the internet, or if it is available on the computer also or the mobile phone also, that also you can upload. So this is the option we were talking about, that image option, and you can upload it from your device, whether it's a computer or a phone, or if you have a camera, you can use that. Or if you're using internet, then from the internet also you can by URL, by the website link, you can also use that as well. So this is how, so we have broadly covered the digital interactive book. What we would also like to now do is to answer some questions on how to upload or publish content on the Gurushala platform. So we would like to, Ipshita, show to our teachers as to how using the explore and the suggest content option, they can upload their own content in the content library. In Gurushala, you see that there's a content library where many of the teachers have also posted their content. So if you go on the content library, you can see that there are these many of the teachers who work with us, and as a program, we are working with more than 20 states and union territories from teachers from there. So many teachers have also uploaded their own content here. So in order to upload any content, whether it is video or PPT on the Gurushala platform, you have to go on the top of the Gurushala page and go to the explore section. So when we click on explore, here you will see that there is on the last option says publish your content. So we can click on publish the content option. And once we click on publish your content, you will get some options of what do you want to publish. So do you want to publish a course, or do you want to publish a content piece? So this is the option you have to select, that you have to click on the content library option and click on create now. So once you click on create now, you can give a title to the content piece. So for example, if you are making a content on, let's say, pronouns, so then you can type the title accordingly. You can mention the name of your name, the name of the author. You can mention the duration and the subject, which is covered in this content piece. You can also select the language in which the content has been created. And then finally, you can then attach a thumbnail to it. So a thumbnail is that image which comes on top of the video when you are searching for it. So you can click on browse and attach the thumbnail. And finally, you can then attach the file by clicking on the browse button, and then it will take you to either your phone gallery, or if you're using the computer, then you can, if you have stored it in your desktop or My Documents, you can upload it from there and click on submit. And once it is submitted, it will be received by our team, and on confirmation from our team, you will get a communication that your content has been published, and you will be able to see it on the Gurushala platform. So with this, Ipshita, we move towards the last leg of our training. We would again continue. We would request teachers to continue asking questions in case they are having any questions. I think one more question which has come from Mr. Subbarao is it's a very good question: as how can we type exponential letters in Google Forms? This is a very important question, because in mathematics especially and in other some other subjects also, we use square and cube and, you know, exponential exponents, superscript, subscripts that we talk about. So Google Form, unfortunately, this facility is not available. But in such situations, what we would recommend is that you write down the equation which has the exponential terms in it on a piece of paper. Or on PowerPoint, and then as an image, you upload the question as an image on the Google form. So if you are writing it on a PowerPoint where exponential equation has been written, you can upload the image. PPT is not uploaded on the Google form, so you have to convert it into an image or into PNG or JPG, or you can take a screenshot and then upload it. Or you can write it on paper and then take a picture and upload the question on the Google form. But the answers can be you can give multiple, you can make it a multiple choice question, and the students have to answer that. I think one more question is coming from Mohammed Chand Khan Ji, who's like, can Gurushala be used offline if there is no internet access? So, sir, many of the resources on Gurushala in the content library, be it the videos, many videos that we have created, or many of the PDF documents, the real life examples, projects, many such resources, worksheets, etc., they can be downloaded offline on your computer or mobile and can be shared offline through a pen drive as well. But all the other content that is available on the content library or the teacher communities requires internet connection, sir. And you can use it in, on a computer and mobile phone as well. So we would encourage teachers to continue asking such these questions, and even after the session in the WhatsApp group as well. Now we would like to move forward, Ipshita, and now move to the very last leg of our session, which is where we will be announcing the winners of yesterday's competition also. So we would like to first mention about the certificate of participation that will be given to all the teachers, Ipshita.
Right. So a very important point to remember here is that we'll be sharing with you a feedback form today after the day two session, and you need to submit this feedback form to us by tomorrow, that is 10 September by midnight, that is 11:59 p.m. And all the participants who will be successfully submitting this feedback form will receive a certificate of participation from us on their respective email IDs by the end of the next week. So Mashood, it's time to announce the winners who have taken part in the task for yesterday and shared with us very innovative ideas of how a collaborative lesson plan can be created. So can we have the names of the winners and the special mentions
So yesterday the task that was given was where we had talked about the collaborative lesson plan. So the collaborative lesson plan, teachers had to submit their idea on the collaborative lesson plan as to which topic they can select and what are the tasks that will be given. So before we announce the winners, we would like to mention some special mentions who were just one small distance away from becoming the winners. So they are K. Ujwala, Padma Sorupaka, and Chilumula Babu. So these are the special mentions who have shared some very good ideas as well. But now let's come to the winners of yesterday's competition. And the winners are in front of us. And the three best entries which we got were from Janu Daisy Rani, Jabeen Asia, and Afroz Jahan, who submitted entries on nation and diversity, the food we eat, and environment biodiversity. So congratulations to all the winners, and also congratulations to the winners, and they will be getting a special prize from Gurushala as well. Our team will reach out to you very soon. And also for the special mentions, we would like to say that please don't feel it's completely fine that you were not able to win, but here we are bringing another competition for all the teachers. And also to the teachers who did not get a chance to participate in this competition, which is the Teacher Innovator Competition for the Jagtial District. So in this competition, as you can see, that there are four steps to this competition. So today, for example, we looked at how to use Google Form and create digital interactive books. So in this competition, you have to create a digital interactive book. For the four steps for that are, first, you have to sign up on www.gurushala.co. The second step is you have to complete the online module on tools for assessment creation, which is given there on Gurushala, which we'll show now. The third step is you have to create a digital interactive book. And then after creating the digital interactive book using Google Form, you have to post the link of the Google Form on the Assessment Idea Teacher Community, which we'll also show now. And it can be on any topic. You can choose any topic which you would like for the digital interactive book. And please do mention your name and name and school details when you post the digital interactive book link. So as we know that this competition's winners will also be getting exciting prizes. We can show it on the next see on the next slide that the deadline is 13 September midnight. So 13 September is a Sunday. So we would request all teachers, we have significant time, we can take the weekend also, to prepare the digital interactive book using Google Form and submit it by 13 September 11:59 p.m. on the Gurushala platform. So Ipshita, now let's see, go to the Gurushala platform and see how this task, this competition can be completed. And how teachers can create the digital interactive book and submit it on time. So we would like to again request all our teachers to note down the steps again. So as we mentioned, the very first step is to sign in, as Ipshita had already showed in that you can sign in using your Google or Facebook or mobile number from there. Once you have signed in, if you're using it on the computer, you will see this interface. On the left side, you will see that there is a leaderboard, there is teacher communities and teaching modules. So you have to click on teaching modules. Once you click on teaching modules, you will see a lot of different types of modules available here. So on the top, you can search for tools for assessment creation. And there are many such modules. There are more than 50 modules on the platform, which are free of cost and which on completion, you get an automatic certificate. So if you can search for tools, you'll automatically get a module on that. So as you can see that there are different types of modules available. They are on classroom management, on teaching strategies, on using of multimedia, using of content, assessment and creation. So here you can see the tools for assessment creation module is also here. When you click on it, you will have to first start the module. So there will be an enroll for free button. We have already enrolled in it, so it's not visible. But this orange kind of a button will be there, which mentions enroll for free. Once you click on enroll for free, then you have to click on start the module. Again, we have started the module here, so it is here. And then you have to click on the module which starts here. So if we go on the module for tools for content creation, the second module, which we can see here, there you will have the relate, explore, assess, and further reading sections. So you can click on relate and click on the first video. And then automatically the module will start. You can see you have to complete all the videos and resources in this module, and you keep clicking on next. So while you keep clicking on next, automatically you will keep moving forward and complete the module. So this is the first step of the competition. Once you have completed this module, you will automatically get an online certificate with your name. The second step is, based on this information and based on the information of the session that we have taken, you have to create using Google Form, you have to create a digital interactive book. And once you have completed the digital interactive book, you have to copy the link of the Google Form and submit it on Teacher Community. So you can click on Teacher Communities. And then here, once we click on Teacher Communities, we have to go on Assessment Ideas, the community on Assessment Ideas. Now, these are a lot of online communities which you will see on Guruśāla, which are based on different ideas and different topics of interest. And here, you will find a lot of different content creators, skill development ideas, it's debatable, hobbies, etc. So you have to click here on the Join button at Assessment Ideas. And with this, here, when we click on, once we have joined, then we have to click on Assessment Ideas. And here, you can see that many teachers have already posted their, different types of resources, digital interactive books, which you can post here as well. So on the top, you will see a Create Post option. And here, you have to you have to mention here what the topic of your digital interactive book is, the name, your name, your school details, and you have to enter the link of your Google Form here. And then click on Done, so it will automatically be posted. So this is a broad demo. We will also be sharing all these instructions and demonstration in the WhatsApp group as well, so that you can refer to it later while you're participating in the competition. So with that, Ipshita, we move towards the very conclusion of today's session. We would like to again thank all the teachers for participating in this session today. Again, this is just the beginning of our engagement. In the YouTube description, you will also find the feedback form and the training docket. And We also conduct trainings on softwares, which where you will find the digital interactive book sample here as well, Ipsita.
Right, Mashood. So with this, Mashood, we have come to the end of the training session today. We really thank all the teachers who have shown so much enthusiasm and they connected with us and participated in various activities conducted in the session. So with this also, I would like to say that you can remain connected with Guruśāla through the Guruśāla Weekly, which happens to be our weekly calendar and weekly newsletter, so that you don't miss any update on Guruśāla. We have various Guruśāla Samvads, we have webinars, and various subject experts come and take questions from teachers, interact with them. We have sessions on various themes related to education and how to make the teaching experience more seamless for the students as well as for the teacher community as well. For any kind of information regarding Guruśāla or any kind of doubt or query, the teachers can reach out to us and they can write to us for any help and assistance using the email ID info@guruśāla.co. Also, we would like to request all the teachers that after the training session gets over, please do log in into the Guruśāla portal and access all the resources, the content library, enroll into the free of cost courses, and also engage on the Guruśāla staff room platform as well as in the teacher communities as well.
Absolutely. So we would like to again thank the district education officer and the AMO of officer of Jagtial district also for playing a very important role in organizing this training and the trainings for all the other blocks and mandals in Jagtial district. We especially would like to again thank all the teachers who are joining us from three mandals of the Jagtial district. And we hope to continue this engagement in the coming times as well. We, like Ipsita mentioned, there'll be many such more events, competitions, and trainings about which you'll keep getting more information on the WhatsApp group. We would request, again, emphasizing that the feedback form is very important because your attendance and the certificate of participation will be based on your submission of the feedback form, for which the deadline is tomorrow, 11:59 p.m. at midnight. So we would request you to please submit the form, and also if there's anyone else from the teachers and from any of your colleagues who has missed the training by any chance, you can share the link of the training sessions with them, and also encourage them to submit the feedback form. They'll also be eligible for the certificate because this is a self-paced training. So those who have been unable to join the live session, they can also participate later. So with this, we would like to thank you, all the teachers again. Thank you for joining us. And we really appreciate the efforts which all the teachers are making during this difficult time. And we would like to wish you all the best. And please do like our YouTube channel as well to stay updated with more updates. Thank you again. Thank you, Ipsita, and thank you all the teachers.